Catherine Boo, in Behind the Beautiful Forevers, eloquently exposes the truth of how the poor survive in New India. Boo uses characters and events in her book to depict how poverty affects the health outcomes of people living in the slums of Mumbai. In India, 456 million citizens live below the poverty line, compared to the 46 million living below the poverty line in the United States. The poverty line in India means living on less than $1.25 a day, whereas in the United States, it is living on less than $30 a day. The average life expectancy is 60 years compared to the U.S. at 82 years old. The infant mortality rate is 90 per 1,000 births compared to the United States at 5.8 per 1,000 live births. From the imagery of sewage lake, dumpster diving, and health conditions like malnutrition and gangrene, poverty continues to affect the lives of slum dwellers. Lack of sanitation and other poverty-related factors such as natural disasters, polluted air, and contaminated water lead to the spread of diseases. There is a high prevalence of tuberculosis in the Anawadi community as exemplified in Abdul's father and numerous other characters. The book describes the public hospitals as unsanitary, leading to the spread of infectious diseases. Doctors accept bribery to perform medical procedures and falsify death certificates. The aftermath of the monsoon season brought increased incidents of diseases, starvation, and civil unrest among the public. Due to scarcity of food, the death toll for starvation is exacerbated following a natural disaster. Street violence becomes pervasive due to food scarcity and financial problems. In addition, children are forced to work, giving up the pursuit of formal education to help their families. Societal expectations of women that exist in the lowest caste of India create a sense of imprisonment for young aspiring women. Being enslaved to household chores and being forced into an unwanted arranged marriage, Meena, an Anawadi girl, chooses one thing in her life she has control over, to commit suicide. This situation is common among many girls like Meena, who face a lack of opportunity as a woman, but specifically a poor woman living in the slums of Anawadi. Currently, there are many programs by the government of India and NGOs that have a mission of alleviating poverty. However, widespread corruption hinders their effectiveness. Making a concerted effort to create accountability for these programs intended to empower the urban poor will help decrease mishandling of funds and increase their efficiency. It is a feat that India has had such steady economic growth rates, but it should not come at the expense of the disenfranchised. Nurturing the young, caring for the sick, and providing more permanent jobs to the people in the slums like Anawadi will do much good for its people and their health outcomes.